Hello students, now I'm going to start question number 2 of exercise 2.4. Now in this question we have, find the reciprocal of each of the following fraction. Classify the reciprocal as proper fraction, improper fraction and whole number. Now what are proper fraction? Proper fraction means if the numerator is smaller than the denominator. So numerator is smaller than the denominator. As for example, say if I take 4 by 7, then 4 is numerator and 7 is denominator. So here 4 is smaller than 7, so this is called proper fraction. And what are improper fraction? Improper fraction means just opposite of this. Here numerator will be greater than the denominator. Like if I take 7 by 4, so 7 is greater than 4. So here we can say that 7 by 4 is an improper fraction. And what are whole numbers? Whole numbers means any number which starts from, as you know that whole number starts from 0. So from 0 onwards, whatever number is there except fraction or decimal, all are whole numbers. Okay. Now, here in the first part we have 3 by 7 and the question is we will have to find the reciprocal of this. Now what are reciprocal? Reciprocal means we will just write the inverse of the fraction. Means like if suppose 3 by 7 is there and 3 is numerator and 7 is denominator. So here we will just exchange the number. Means numerator will become the denominator and denominator will become the numerator. Okay, so the reciprocal of 3 by 7 will be 7 by 3. So here 7 will go up and 3 will come down. Okay, now let's start. So here we will have to write 3 by 7. We will have to write the reciprocal of 3 by 7. So reciprocal of 3 by 7 is 7 by 3 and then we will have to write that whether these are proper fraction, improper fraction and whole number. Okay. Now here we can see that 7 is greater than 3. So that means numerator is greater than 3. So we can say that 7 by 3 is an improper fraction. And one thing I want to tell you students, like here we will have to see, classify the reciprocal as proper fraction, improper fraction and whole numbers. We will not classify the fraction which is given. Means we will not classify 3 by 7. We will just classify 7 by 3, which is the reciprocal of 3 by 7. So 7 by 3 is an improper fraction. Now in the next part we have 5 by 8. Now the reciprocal of 5 by 8 is 8 by 5. Denominator will be numerator and numerator will be denominator. And here as 8 is greater than 5 means numerator is greater than the denominator. So we can say that it is an improper fraction. Okay. Now in the third part we have 9 by 7 and the reciprocal of 9 by 7 is 7 by 9. We will just exchange the number. Okay, so it will be 7 by 9. Now 7 by 9, here we can see that numerator is less than the denominator. So this is a proper fraction. So we'll write proper fraction. Okay, next. Now the reciprocal of 6 by 5. In the fourth part we have 6 by 5. So the reciprocal of 6 by 5 is 5 by 6 and 5 by 6 is proper fraction as numerator is smaller than the denominator. So this is a proper fraction. Okay. Now in the next part we have 12 by 7. So the reciprocal of 12 by 7 is 7 by 12, and 7 by 12 is proper fraction, as numerator is less than the denominator. Okay, next. Now in the sixth part we have 1 by 8. The reciprocal of 1 by 8 is 8 by 1. Okay, or we can write this, we can write it as 8. Now 8 is neither proper fraction nor improper fraction. This is not a fraction, this is a whole number. Okay, now the last part of this question is 1 by 11. So reciprocal of 1 by 11 is 11 by 1, which is 11, right? Now 11 is whole number, because this is not a fraction, this is a whole number. Okay, so this was the last part of number 2. Thank you, students.